Ladies and gentlemen, what you're about to witness is dignified deformation executed by unprecedented precision. Der Ringgeneral Gunther!
Der Ringgeneral in the flesh. Gunther is setting modern records for his run as Intercontinental Champion, and after winning at WrestleMania, it seems destined to go all the way. But what if there was something else? Something more? What if Gunther wanted that more? Well, that's exactly what we're here to do, right? Gunther is about to become WWE Champion. But before we can do that, we need to take that pesky Intercontinental title away from him. Yes, I know, records are meant to be broken and all that, but this is my video. Sorry, got carried away there. Anyways, after defeating Drew McIntyre and Sheamus, there seems to be almost no one left to face Gunther, and he knows it. His ego is through the roof. Well, by his standards, anyway. We get to Backlash, and Gunther is able to rack up another victory, this time over a very fresh and talented LA Knight. Not to worry, LA. Your time will come. But Gunther has someone else on the horizon. And the best part? He has no idea who it's gonna be. We're back stateside, and after a few more weeks of Gunther domination. Now that's filthy. We're ready for that someone else. The whole of Imperium is out for what should be a chaotic tag team title match. Gunther is watching on at ringside as, despite giving their best efforts, Kaiser and Vinci just fall short to Zayn and Owens. Gunther isn't happy though, and he jumps the ring. It's a 3-on-2 assault of the champions, and Gunther has Zayn lined up. And there's that someone, right on cue, a ghost from Gunther's past, Ilya Dragunov is on SmackDown. He goes after Imperium and helps to clean house, sending the champion over the top rope. Gunther's confidence is looking shaken now. The man who ended his first legendary reign is looking to do it with this one. And so it seems written. The next week, Dragunov makes his in-ring debut on SmackDown, taking care of Gunther's right-hand man in Kaiser. And with the stare down, all the emotions rush back to Gunther of what happened in NXT, and how he's desperate to make sure that doesn't happen again. Shines the desperation, with Gunther making the call out. After the beatdown, Gunther demands that he face Dragunov on Money in the Bank. Well, in that case, what are we waiting for? And after a massive brawl at the SmackDown before the huge event in London, that's worth asking again. We haven't even got to the title of the video yet. So let's do this. Welcome to the big leagues, Ilya. Gunther is in his stomping ground, just a few hours away from Riyadh's legendary five-star match with Sheamus, and he's about to have another one here. Nothing has been forgotten from either man from their NXT encounter, and man alive are they tearing each other apart. Listen to this. Oh yeah, that's the good stuff. London is on fire for these two, and they absolutely deserve it. Let's take it down to the booth for this one. Man, these two just do not stop with their offense. Ilya looks battered, but he will never quit. Ilya's got him down. He's looking for Torpedo Moscow. Oh, what a lariat from Gunther. He's got him. Powerbomb. Nailed him. Cover. Dragunov kicks out at two. Yeah, this is going straight in the wrestling spank bank. Gunther is desperate to right the wrong from NXT and break the record for the longest title reign. Can he do it? We're going to the corner. Gunther is pulling Ilya up top. Oh my goodness. Will he hit it? Top rope countered by Ilya. To the corner. Beat on Moscow! But it's not enough! A second! And he covers! Ilya Dragunov is Intercontinental Champion!
What a match. And what a moment for Dragunov. History has repeated itself. Your new Intercontinental Champion, Ilya Dragunov. And your now former Intercontinental Champion, Gunther. But as I'm sure you know, this is far from over. Oh, buddy, we've only just begun. Later that night, it's the iconic Money in the Bank ladder match. We've got all the big names out here tonight, and here comes Santos Escobar. Are you kidding me? Gunther is going to force himself into this thing? You're damn right he is. The bell is rung, and Gunther's the final member of this match, and he's on a tear through everyone, paying no attention to the beating he took earlier this night. Chop, chop, chop. Lariat! He's going through them all! Oh, there's an incoming Seth Rollins! Never mind! We are getting into the nitty-gritty of it now, though. Gunther's going for the briefcase, but there's Riddle to meet him! They strike it out! RKO off the ladder! Surely, that's Gunther out of this match now! They're all falling down! There's only two left! Cody Rhodes and Seth Rollins still stand, and they are fighting up on the ladder! Oh, here we go. Could this be where the visionary has his next steps lined up? Or is it one step closer to Rhodes finishing the story? Rollins, he's stumbling. Down he goes. Rhodes is there with the briefcase. No, it's the bloodline. Oh, they've sent Rhodes off the ladder. Damn it. And now they're directing traffic. They're telling Gunther to go after Rhodes! He's got him up on the outside!
Wait, no!
No! Throw the ladder! Rhodes is folded in half! Gunther, he's in! He's climbing the ladder! There's no one around! Gunther is Mr. Money in the Bank!
Have the bloodline recruited Gunther to ensure he stops Cody from finishing his story? Let's see. The next SmackDown, Gunther is interviewed backstage on winning the briefcase, but before he even has a chance to speak, he's got company. The tribal chief would like your attention, Gunther. And suddenly, the interview is put to one side. Off works Gunther, following Heyman. I think there is something there. And when asked about it the week after, Gunther is rather vague, simply saying, "It's just business." Now, if you'll excuse me. Excuse him? But he was scheduled to give the interview from last week again. Keep your camera on him. Oh, wait! Oh, come on! This is what you call business? You're so much better than this, Gunther! Powerbomb to Cody on the locker room floor. This is sickening. Heath doesn't see it that way. His ego is on full display at the end of the show, and for good reason. But as Reigns runs down Cody and his desire to end this story, is an uninvited guest. And here he is! Gunther makes his way out, and he makes it clear to Roman. Just because they have an agreement doesn't mean Gunther won't change his mind on it. And in case Reigns steps over his marks, there's a briefcase in his name. A briefcase that, if Roman isn't careful, will end that legacy. And suddenly, Reigns' joke inside is replaced with a look of intensity as the show goes off the air. Despite their best efforts, this story is entering its final chapters. Cody Rhodes continues to overcome the world and needs to do just one thing to win his match at SummerSlam against Roman Reigns. That's right, beat Gunther. It is a huge main event on SmackDown, and with Reigns watching intently on the stage, Gunther goes to work, pulling Rhodes down. It is a brutal battle for Cody. Is there a chance of him overcoming it? We're about to find out. Gunther is doing everything that Reigns wants from him. Their agreement seems to be paying dividends for the tribal chief. Cody's fighting, but with everything he's gone through these past months, it feels like a losing battle. Gunther's got the end in his sights. Powerbomb, no! Cody counters it! and he's going for it now. Gunther's looking rocky. Cody Cannon. But Gunther kicks out. Rhodes is calling for it. Oh, wait. That's Solo. And Solo's distracted the ref. Ray's Superman punch. Like clockwork. They've done it again. Gunther's got him up. Powerbomb. Rhodes reverses. Cover. Shoulders down. Cody Rhodes is going to SummerSlam. He's done it. We're in the final chapter. Will the story be written in Detroit?
Uh-oh. You messed up, Gunther. And boy, oh boy, is Roman going to make that clear. On the final SmackDown to SummerSlam, no less, Reigns sends his message to Gunther's failure. Ludwig Kaiser is laid out backstage, and there is a figure standing over him. Solo Sikoa. He goes to walk off, but he's got one final statement to send. This agreement has quickly fallen apart. What'll happen on the night? Let's find out. Detroit is glued to the action. They want to see the story be finished. They want to see Cody Rhodes do what he couldn't at WrestleMania. The match is intense, and we are seeing just what it means to both of them. All the dedication and suffering that Rhodes has gone through to get to this moment. Can he finally do it tonight? The match is wearing on, and they're kicking out of everything the other has to offer. Cody has him, but here comes the cavalry. Solo is ready to do what he did at WrestleMania. Here we go. Usos are taken out in that brutal ladder match earlier tonight. Solo is here, but what about the insurance policy? Gunther hasn't been seen or heard from all night, but back in the ring, Cody Cannon! He's got him! Crossroads! Another! Finish the damn story, Cody! Oh, there's Heyman though, with the distraction. Solo's barging in, but not this time! Crossroads to Solo! There's Reigns out! Back up! Spear! Cody kicks out at two! Roman is stunned and he's looking to the entranceway! He's looking for the insurance policy and there he is! Gunther! He's here! He's standing at the top of the ramp and he's looking around! His tent is back on him! Gunther is walking out on Roman! Can you believe it? The Tribal Chief, he's gonna have to do it alone! In the corner, spear, count it! Crossroads! Another! Third time's the charm! He covers Roman! Cody Rhodes has done it! The undisputed Universal Champion! He finished the story. He did it. Cody Rhodes has overcome the bloodline and done what no one else could do in over 1,000 days. A moment that will live in history for more reason than one. Gunther cashes in. He wants to be champion. He demands the match to be made for the WWE Championship alone. And here he goes. Powerbomb from Gunther. But Cody kicks out. This is unreal shit. Gunther had no doubt in his mind that he had him. He's looking for another. Oh, but Cody slips out. Crossroads. Gunther kicks out now! Come on, Cody! You got this! He's going to the top with Detroit on his side! Moonsault evaded! Oh, what a lariat!
biscuit. A third powerbomb to Cody. Gunther is WWE champion. Darin General has made the moment his. Cody Rhodes may have finished the story, but now there's a new book being written. One of the new WWE champion. SummerSlam goes down in history. Roman is truly dethroned, but there's a new force at the top of WWE. Cody Rhodes is one, but the one that stands at the end of SummerSlam as the new WWE champion is the other, and that is...
Dead!